Hello guys, it's Deep Shah over here and today I'm going to show you how to create this portrait tree painting effect in Photoshop. Also, if you want to learn how to create such cool effects using Photoshop, then hit that subscribe button if you haven't already. So without wasting any time, let's get started. So the first step over here is we only need to keep the model and remove the background from this image. So for that, select Quick Selection tool. And then using Quick Selection tool, make the selection of the model in the image. You can increase and decrease the size of the brush using the square brackets key of your keyboard. So this looks good over here, so it's okay if your selection is not proper. Anyways, we won't be needing that model. So after that, click on Add Layer Mask icon to remove the background and only keep the selection. So as you can see, the background has been removed and only the model is there over here. So after that, right click on the mask of the model image and then select Apply Layer Mask over there. After that, using Move tool, place the model at the center of the image. So this looks perfect. After that, create a new layer and then bring that layer at the bottom. After that, select Paint Bucket tool and then set the foreground color as white. And then using Paint Bucket tool, fill the background with white color. So now this looks good. After that, again make the model image layer active by clicking on it. After that, bring in the tree silhouette image over here. Download link for the tree silhouette image is in the description below. Now click on this tick icon to place the image over here for now. So now we only need to keep the black part of the image, that is the birds and the branches of the tree, and remove the golden background over here. So for that, go to select. And then select color range over there. After that, using the picker, select any black color from the image and then set the fuzziness according to the details you want to be displayed over here. So 80 looks fine for this image and then click on OK. So as you can see, it gives you the selection of all the black parts in the image. After that, click on Add Layer Mask icon to only keep the selection and remove the rest of the background. So as you can see, only the selection is present over here and the background has been removed. But also, as you can see, the color of the branches and that of bird is not exactly black. So first we have to convert it to black. So for that, right click on the tree image and then select rasterize layer over there. After that, right click on the mask of the tree image and then select apply layer mask over there. After that, press Ctrl and click on the icon of the tree image to give you the selection of that image. So as you can see, we now have the selection of that image. After that, set the foreground color to black. And then select Paint Bucket tool. And then using Paint Bucket tool, click on the selection as follows. So this will fill the selection with that of black color. After that, press Ctrl plus D to deselect the selection. So now this looks proper, but we still need to mask the image of the tree with that of the model. So for that, press Ctrl and click on the icon of the model layer, which will give you the selection of that model. After that, click on Add Layer Mask icon, which will mask the tree image layer with that of model. So as you can see, only the image of the tree that was inside of the model is present and rest of the image has been removed. After that, make the model image layer active by clicking on it. And then reduce the fill of the model layer to 0%, so the model layer won't be displayed anymore. After that, make the image of the tree image layer active by clicking on it. Now we need to scale and place this tree image over here properly. So for that, unlink the tree image with that of that mask by clicking on this link icon over here. After that, press Ctrl plus T. And then you can scale and place the image accordingly. While scaling, press Shift to scale evenly. So this looks good. After that, click on the stick icon to place it. So like this way, we need to fill the whole model image layer with that of the tree structure. So for that, create a duplicate of the current tree image layer by pressing Ctrl plus J. And then using Move tool, place it properly. After that, press Ctrl plus T to scale and rotate the image. Press Shift while scaling to scale evenly. You can rotate it as well. So this looks good. After that, click on the stick icon to place it. So like this, we fill the whole model image layer by creating the duplicate of the tree image layer. Also, if you want to remove the parts of the tree image, so for that, make the mask of that tree image layer active by clicking on it, and then select brush tool, and then select brush as soft round. After that, set the foreground color as black, and then using brush tool, click and hover over the image which you want to remove. So this looks perfect, but as you can see, the shape of the model is quite not visible over here. So for that, make the model image layer active by clicking on it. And then click on add layer style icon and then select blending options over there. After that, click on the stroke option. After that, set the size of the stroke to 7 pixels or you can set it accordingly as well. Then the position of the stroke should be outside. Blend mode to normal, opacity to 100% and the color of the stroke should be black or the color you have chosen for the tree, and then click on OK. After that, click on OK. So as you can see, the structure of the model is now visible over here, but I still want to remove some of the outline of the model to make it look more realistic. So for that, right click on the model layer and then select convert to smart object over there. After that, click on add layer mask icon and then select brush tool. After that, select the brush as soft round and then set the foreground color to black. After that, using brush tool, click and hover over the parts of the outline of the model which you want to remove. You can increase and decrease the size of your brush using the square bracket keys of your keyboard. So now this looks proper, but I still want to add gradient at the background to make it look more proper. So for that, make the background layer active by clicking on it. And then click on create new fill or adjustment layer icon and then select gradient option over there. After that, set the gradient as black to white. Then set the style as radial. Set the angle to 90 degree. Then click on this reverse option and then scale it to 200%. After that, click on OK. After that, reduce the opacity of the gradient layer to 40%. So now this looks proper, but now to make it look like a painting, we have to give a paper effect over here. So for that, make the top layer active by clicking on it. After that, press Ctrl plus Shift plus Alt plus E to merge all the visible layers into a single layer. So as you can see, a new layer has been created, which is a merge layer of all the layers below. To show you the effect, I'm hiding all the layers. So now we need to give this paper effect into this merged image layer. So for that, go to filter and then select filter gallery option. After that, expand the texture folder and then select texturizer effect over there. After that, set the scaling to 200% and then set the relief to 5 and then click on OK. To show you the effect of what we just did, I'm zooming into the image. So as you can see, after adding the paper effect, it looks like as if it was painted over here. So that's it guys, this will give you your portrait tree painting effect in Photoshop. Now if you guys like this video, then hit the like button. Also share it to the ones who might be interested in such videos and subscribe to the channel for more videos in Photoshop. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.